let's quickly go ahead and focus on domino logic family. So in domino, we know that it's same like dynamic with an added static inverter, correct? So the number of NMOSes and PMOSes, let's quickly do that. NMOS for dynamic was K plus 1. So for domino, it's going to be K plus 2 because 1, this is dynamic, plus 1 NMOS of my static inverter. PMOS, 1 for dynamic plus 1 of static inverter, correct? Static power dissipation, same like dynamic, no. Rail to rail output, yes, you get perfect output. You need to size, you don't need to size this. Can you cascade a domino with another domino? Absolutely yes, you can. Only dynamic circuit families are not to be cascaded, so you can do. Some of the advantages and disadvantages. It overcomes the monotonicity problem with dynamic circuit had, so that's an advantage. With the help of charge keeper circuits, it can also prevent charge leakage, so again that's an advantage. The only drawback here is that they are non-inverting, because at every output of dynamic you need to connect an inverter, so they are non-inverting circuits, so that's a drawback. This is domino. Let's quickly go ahead and complete the final family, which is nothing but CMOS transmission gates. So in CMOS transmission gates, we know that same like static, if there are K inputs, 2 input, 3 input, 4 input, you will need K number of PMOSes, K number of NMOSes. They will also like static have no static power dissipation because there is no path from VDD to ground. Rail to rail output, yes, you get a perfect 1 or a perfect 0. You don't need to size them. So no for rest assured. Can you cascade? Yes, we have seen so many examples where you can cascade one transmission gate to another, so we can cascade it. Though cascading will have its own drawbacks, we can easily cascade it. Now some of the advantages and disadvantages of CMOS TG. One clear advantage is it provides a low resistance path between VDD and ground, so we get a perfect voltage swing. Now disadvantages might be a bit difficult for anyone to understand without understanding the physical design or the layout. So I'm just going to mention in very brief, because of physical design and because of the parasitic delay of the transmission gates, with multiple series transmission gates, when transmission gates are connected in series and when the layout happens of this transmission gates, what happens is the delay keeps on increasing rapidly because of the internal diffusion capacitance. So you cannot connect more than two transmission gates in series. This one can understand only when one understands how to make the layout of this. For the time being, you can say that the parasitic delay increases with increase in series connection of TGs. So that's one drawback here. The other drawback again is, suppose if the transmission gate, let's say this is 0 and this is 1, that means this has to hold its charge. But again, the problem will happen that it might be corrupted because of noise, and at that point of time, the output is tri-stated, right? Means a high impedance, means it has to hold whatever is present, but it becomes susceptible to noise in this case is because a slight noise here on any of this signal, you know, will allow the input to be passed, which is not to be the correct value. So it's susceptible to noise. So in summary, we have seen all the logic families with their advantages, disadvantages, and some of the basic parameters of comparison. We saw their circuits as well. So I think we are all set to understand all these families' comparison and which one is better for a particular design depends on an application. Hope you have followed. Stay tuned for further clips and thank you very much.